Welcome. In this lesson, we'll go through the process of adding hair to a separated scalp in Ornatrix for 3ds Max. You'll learn two main workflows: using presets to build hair quickly, and creating it from scratch by drawing guides or hair directly. We'll look at how the key modifiers work, how to control width, density, and clumping, and how to shape and comb hair efficiently. By the end, you'll be able to create your own basic hairstyle from start to finish. We have a character with a detached scalp. The full body mesh is only needed for collision detection. For example, when you have long hair. For now, it can be hidden. Now let's talk about how to add hair to the scalp. There are two main methods: using presets through Add Hair or the Ornatrix Quick Hair icon. Drawing guides or hair directly on the scalp. If you select the scalp and click the Quick Hair icon, or go to Ornatrix, Add Hair, the Select Groom window will appear with basic presets. Each preset adds a set of modifiers that perform specific functions. Let's start with the basic preset. It adds four modifiers: GuidesFromMesh, which generates guides from the scalp mesh; Edit Guides, used to edit those guides. For example, you can select an area and comb it with the brush tool. To work only on the selection, enable Affect Selected Only. HairFromGuides, which generates strands from the guides and offers different interpolation methods. ChangeWidth, which adjusts strand thickness. You can set the width and shape the taper from roots to tips with a curve. Other presets, such as Feather, FurBall, or Mesh Plumage, are aimed at feathers or fur. We won't go into them in this series, since here we're focused on hair. Instead, let's look at the HairBall preset. It adds more modifiers than the basic setup. In addition to the four you already know, it includes StrandGravity, which controls the effect of gravity on the hair. This is useful for quickly shaping a hairstyle. Strand Frizz, which introduces micro deformations for realism. Real hair is never perfectly straight, and external factors such as humidity create irregularities. Frizz deforms strands along their length without changing overall length. Ox Clump, which groups strands into clumps, adding natural variation. Clumps can be created randomly or based on guides, where each guide becomes the center of a clump. With these modifiers, the HairBall preset can be used as a quick way to create a base hairstyle. If you want to build everything from scratch without a preset, you begin with GuidesFromMesh. Another option is to draw guides or hair directly on the scalp. To do this, select the scalp and apply an Edit Guides modifier. It's often convenient to set up a quick access modifier toolbar in 3ds Max. Click Configure Modifier Sets. Choose how many slots you want and drag the needed modifiers onto the panel. When drawing guides, it's better to first duplicate the scalp. One copy will be used as the scalp geometry, the other for the hair stack. In Edit Guides, you can use draw strands to pull guides directly from the scalp. Or use brush mode with the Create Brush tool for controlled placement. Brush settings give you several options. Random scatters guides within the brush radius. Center places one guide in the center of the brush. Vertex creates guides at mesh vertices. Face center places them at polygon centers. You can adjust count to control how many guides are created per stroke, spacing to set the distance between them. and Shift plus B to change brush radius. For quick hairstyles, random with count around 10, and spacing at 1 works well. Once you have some guides, add Hair from Guides. You can add this modifier in 3 ways, from the panel through Ornatrix. Add Hair from Guides, or via the Ornatrix toolbar using this icon. By default, it creates 300 strands, with preview strand fraction at 20%. Setting this to 100% will show all strands. Another method is to draw hair directly. To do this, add Edit Guides to the hair object. Add Hair from Guides, and set root count and preview strand fraction to 0. In Hair from Guides, choose Guide as Hair. Now, any guides you draw become real strands immediately. If the black guide gizmos get in the way, disable them with Hide Guides Gizmo. You can also enable symmetry in the brush via mirror brush changes, x-axis, so strokes are mirrored across both sides of the scalp. For a clean start, draw a small number of hairs to block out the shape. Then comb with the comb brush. At first you can comb symmetrically, then disable symmetry for freeform adjustments. Different combing algorithms provide different behavior. Legacy adds an FK rig to each strand, as if it has bones. Local lets you adjust strands locally without pulling roots or tips. Optimized pulls the entire strand. For example, to lift roots without stretching the full strand, use Local. You can then add ChangeWidth to adjust strand thickness and taper. At this point, you'll have a basic hairstyle. But density may look sparse. To fix that, add another Edit Guides above Hair from Guides. Switch it to Brush Mode and enable Hide Guides Gizmo. Select Create Brush and set Count to 100, spacing to 0.05, and change Tracking to Strand. Now, painting across the surface will add more strands while keeping the existing shape. This way, thin spots are filled in and the hairstyle looks complete. Congratulations! You've created your first basic hairstyle in Ornatrix.